Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to be starting with exercise 4A, that is chapter factorization for class 9 ICSE from Frank AMU books. So the overall question for this exercise is factorize the following. So the first question says 12 a squared b minus 16 ab squared minus 28 a squared b squared. So the common factor of all the numbers in this question is 4, because 12 is divisible by 4, so is 16 and so is 28. So I can just take this over here, that is 4, and one thing that is common in all the numbers is a and b occurring at least once. So what I can do is 4ab, and then I'll just see like how many times is 4 multiplied to get 12. So it's like 4 3s are 12, so I just write 3 and a because a square is there, minus 4 4s are 16 and b because it's b square, minus 4 6s are, or 4 7s are 28 rather, and we are having ab because it's a square b square. So that's the answer for this question, just in a small line. Let's move on to the second question. It's 7ax minus 7x plus ap minus p. Now when you're having four terms, you just group the terms. So here you can group any two terms together. It could also be that you group the first and third and the second and fourth, but in this one it's easier to group the first and second and third and fourth. So I'm going to group these and these. The common factor in this number is 7x, because 7 occurs in every number and so does x. So I can take 7x into, and the thing missing in this number from 7x is a minus, and 7x we have taken completely outside, so it's 1. Plus, now p is common in both the terms, so I take p over here, and a again is missing, minus 1. Now when we are having the common parts equal or the same, what you can do is just take them aside, and then whatever is in the uncommon part, that is outside the brackets, you club them inside a bracket and multiply it. So 7x plus p, and that's the answer for your second question. Moving on to the third question, it is cd minus c minus 4d plus 4. So again, it's very simple to club these terms. It's again the first and second and third and fourth. So again, C is common, so I take C, and D is missing because D is the term more than C. So I just write D minus 1. Again, minus, we have 4 over here. So 4, and I am having D minus 1. I take the common D minus 1 together, and then we club C and minus 4, that is C minus 4 together, and there we are having the answer for our third question. Moving on to the fourth question, AX minus AY minus 5X plus 5Y. So we can just group the first and second and third and fourth in this case as well. Well, these questions are pretty basic, but the next that we get in 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th, they are kind of complex, and we'll be doing that in the next video. So I'm having A as a common factor in this, so I take A out. What remains is X minus Y in the bracket, because if I take A out of both the terms, what remains is X and Y, and the sign in between is minus. Now, to get these terms together, because the terms inside the bracket have to be the same, and if I take 5 out of this, I guess minus x plus y. So that's what I get, but I want to get the signs opposite. So what I do is, I take minus 5 out of this. So since minus 5 is out of here, I get x. And to get the 5 out, I have taken the minus 5 out. So it's a minus y over here. So both x minus y and x minus y are same on both the sides. Now what I do is I take x minus y in one bracket and a minus 5 in the other bracket, because that's what is on the outside of the two brackets. So that is the answer for our fourth question. Moving on to the last question for this video, that is the fifth question. We have 2a cube minus a square minus 6a plus 3. Now, again, I'm going to take the first and second and third and fourth terms over here. So, it's 2a cube minus a square. According to me, a square is what's common in both, because even in a cube, you have a square into a. That is a raised to 2 plus 1. That's why it's a raised to 3. So, you can write a raised to 2 plus 1. So, if you take a square out as a common number, you get 2a minus 1 over here. Now, like the previous question, since I want 2a minus 1, it's going to come in the form minus 2a plus 1. So, I'll just take out the negative 3 over here, because that's a common factor in these numbers. So, I basically get 2a, because minus 3 into 2a, I get minus 6a. And minus 1, I'm going to have the same term, because minus, if I take out the minus 3, minus 1, it will just give you 3. Now, I take 2a minus 1 over here, because we know they are same, and then club these two terms, that is a square minus 3, and that is the answer for our fifth question. So guys, don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you like this video, and also comment down below if you want any other chapters or any other questions explanation, and surely do comment down below what other improvements do you expect in my videos. Thanks for watching.